Head injury is the commonest cause of death and disability in people aged under 40. Mild traumatic brain injury, sometimes called concussion, accounts for 1.2 million hospital visits each year in the UK. Now, although we call it mild, it leads to disproportionate impact on future health. And this is echoed by Headway, the brain injury charity. Peter McCabe, the chief executive, has added his support and commented, "We know that even a seemingly minor head injury can have a major impact on a patient's life." Now, the consequences of these mild traumatic brain injuries are profound, with 3 in 10 not able to work at 12 months. The longer-term effects include post-traumatic headache, memory dysfunction, and poor mental health, with post-traumatic stress disorder in some, as well as balance issues. Returning to work, to sport, to military duty is not possible in up to a third in the UK. Now, there are many causes of traumatic brain injury. Road traffic accidents, assault, falls, sports-related head injuries, and in military personnel, both in peace and even more so during conflict, head injury is common. But identifying those most at risk of these disabling consequences is currently not possible. So this UK research programme is the first of its kind. We are collaborating closely with our colleagues from the Ministry of Defence.
I'm delighted that the Defence Medical Services, including the Defence Medical Rehabilitation Centre at Stamford Hall, will be working hand in glove with class-leading civilian colleagues and the National Rehabilitation Centre programme. I fully support this groundbreaking research, which I'm confident will lead to significant clinical innovation to benefit military and civilian patients and have translational positive impact for sporting activities from grassroots to elite levels.
This programme of work brings together an outstanding multidisciplinary team of researchers from around the UK, coupled with top UK innovation. The study is designed to identify groundbreaking evidence to inform swifter diagnosis, swifter treatment, and enhanced long-term management that will benefit across the board from military personnel to civilians and sports-related brain injury. This study will also have relevance to military veterans with mild traumatic brain injury by providing indicators of head injury and a focus for future care. Our vision is to identify clinically relevant, practical approaches that can be moved directly into patient care.